It's a long-held goal for high school football teams. Hold a practice on Thanksgiving. That means teams are still playing in the state playoffs.
And Cole, will some of our local teams be practicing this coming Thursday?
There will be a little pigskin and turkey for a couple of teams. Not as many as we would have liked. It's been a little bit of a rough go the last 2 weeks of the playoffs, but we will have some football coming up here this week. When we brought you the Bold City Showcase back the first weekend of the high school football season, we saw Bulls lose to the University Christian in the debut for head coach Matt Toblin. And to be honest, at that point, I thought this might be a difficult adjustment for the Bulldogs. New head coach, new assistants, new system. But after that loss to UC, the Bulldogs found themselves getting into a little bit of a groove. They won 9 straight to get to the third round of the playoffs tonight, where they hosted Bradford. To Bulls we go. Beautiful night at the Bulls school campus. And two good teams going at it here tonight. Bulldogs up 3-0 in the first quarter. They started a drive from their own 3-yard line. Cade Frew off and running. One of his big runs, a 42-yard run. He would finish with 200 yards rushing in the game. That would set up Ben Netting to Davis Ellis. Gets behind the defense, 43 yards for the touchdown. Bulls up 10-0 just 8 minutes into the game. But don't count out Bradford, especially with the Tornadoes defense. Netting rolling out, throwing, and he is intercepted by Nedro Davis, and he's gone. 97 yards the other way for the touchdown, and we've got a ball game. Extra point missed, so it's a 10-6. Bulls lead after the pick six for the Tornadoes. Bulldogs added another field goal, led 13-6 as we enter the fourth quarter. Just under 7 minutes to go now. Chance to ice it, but Frew stopped by Davis on the 1 yard line. Bulldogs settle for a field goal, take a 16-6 lead. 2:26 to play. Bradford, fourth and goal from the 9. Pedro Carter. And this one is stopped by Hayden Schwartz. Bulldogs win it 16-6. They'll host Coco next week for a spot in the state championship. We mentioned University Christian beat Bulls to open the season. The Christians have been playing at a very high level all season long. Tonight, they hosted Tallahassee McClay. A UC win would send them to the state semifinals. To University Boulevard we go. UC picks this one up early, opening quarter. UC down 14-7 before DeSirio Riles takes it on the quarterback keeper. Ties things up at 14-all. After an interception by UC, Christians go to the air. Riles up top to Marcus Molds, 40 yards. Touchdown, 21-14, University Christian leading. Second quarter and what may have been the play of the game, McClay down inside the UC 5, in position for points with defensive back Oral Gray, fights for possession, comes up with the interception at the 1 yard line. And on the ensuing drive, UC would make them pay. Jerome Manning, the big fellow, the tight end with a touchdown, 28-14 UC. Trying to nail this one down. UC goes to the air again on fourth down and a mile, and Riles hits Gray on the sideline, holds on. First and goal, UC. 3 plays later, Riles finds the end zone again. UC wins it 35-28. They'll be on the road next week at Lakeland Victory Christian. We also have Lee on the road at Escambia in Pensacola. First time since 1984 these two teams were playing back then. Emmett Smith was playing for Escambia. Lee fumbled on their first possession, and on the very next play, they take advantage of Escambia. 7-0 Gators at that point. It was 14-0 Escambia when the Lee defense steps up. It's an interception by Devin Smith, and this is a pick six. Gets on the board. Lee up, down rather, 14-7. On the ensuing drive, Smith, the throw to JoJo Blackman. Touchdown, Escambia, 23-7 at that point. Right now in the fourth quarter, Escambia leading 32-13. Other scores in 1A. Union County went to Madison County, did what so many have done, lost at Boot Hill, a shutout 49-0. Meanwhile, in Georgia, both Brunswick and Glen Academy lose their games on the road in the second round, so their seasons come to a close. In 5A, Ware County loses at home to Buford, so the Gators' season done there. Pierce County sees their undefeated season come to an end in double overtime, losing 32-29 at home to Hart County. What a heartbreaker. So for all the teams in our area, only Bulls and UC remain alive in the playoffs, and only Bulls will have a home game next week. Getting married?